Hello Internet and welcome to a new episode on my channel. After some weeks without new videos, I have some new content in the production pipeline. Even though I did not produce additional videos, of course I still was working on different wood and art projects. This leads me to today's Splendor modeling topic. A new nozzle for my workshop vacuum cleaner. This is a nice opportunity to show you a precision modeling technique in Blender for 3D printing, which you can use to produce fast and accurate results without using CAD software. Let's start with the modeling. The first thing I usually do is I change the scene unit system settings for precision modeling and use the metric unit measurement system and millimeters as a unit. According to this, I change the overlay grid resolution. In addition, I change the matcap settings to have a better visualization of the surface. We use two base meshes as a starting point, the combination of a cube and the cylinder mesh. Add the base meshes to the scene and adjust the dimensions, either using the Elements Dimensions dialog directly or the modeling tools. To provide the possibility to join the geometry between the cube and the cylinder, and to have a clean topology, I need to split the cube to match the edge count of the cylinder. The top and bottom faces in the cylinder can be deleted. Later I will use the subdivision modifier. This will affect the dimensions of the geometry, if not restricted by additional geometry. Therefore I add additional edges near the bottom and the top of the cylinder. We can join the cube and the cylinder object to one object with one geometry. After that we can bridge the edge loops of the top edges to connect the geometry between the cube and the cylinder to form our base model. To be efficient, I split the base model in half and use the mirror modifier. This way I only have to mirror the model on one side and the mirrored side of the model has a symmetrical geometry. Make sure the cutting edge vertices match the mirror axis, but more on that later. Now it is time to define a rough shape. The main tools or working modes are the snap function with absolute grid snapping enabled and the proportional editing. I use the snap function to precisely change the geometry or scale in the orthogonal view and use the grid as a snap reference. The proportional editing mode can help them to model organic flowing shapes, play with the different curves and different sizes of the effect areas. If you use a too big effect area, you will also change the position of the mirror edge vertices, and this in combination with the subdivision modifier will be visible as wrong geometry afterwards. There is one plugin that I use all the time, the Measure It plugin. You can activate it in the Blender add-on list in the Preferences dialog. Here I use the plugin to create a measure line between two vertices. But we can also use it for other measurements. You can set the measurement unit to millimeter and there will stay and the measurement line will stay until you delete it. But some of the Blender functions and if you apply modifiers will change the model geometry and then you have to reset the measurement.
Make sure you apply the scale and rotation before you work with modeling functions or apply modifiers. In the Blender data model, all the edges have their original size and the scale factor, and only if you apply the transformation or let's say the scale and rotation, then the final values will be set in the data model.
Now I modify the model to realize my design ideas, either by modifying vertices individually or by using the modeling functions in edit mode. Keep in mind that you can change the transform orientation in case you need a different axis or directions during the edit process. For example, if you want to move a vertice or if you want to change the orientation of a face. To open the nozzle a bit at the top, I use proportional processing but with linear placement. This interpolates and positions the vertices in a straight line. I use the Solidify modifier to give the model some thickness. What you can see here is the problem I mentioned earlier. Not all of the vertices at the mirror edge are really on the mirror axis. This has to be corrected and then all the artifacts will be gone.
It can be fixed easily, just adjust the position of the mirror edge vertices to match the mirror edge axis. For example, set the X position of a vertice on the mirror axis to 0.
So after the cleanup, I can use the Solidify modifier again. Please check the order of the modifiers because this can lead to different results. I use the Solidify modifier with the negative thickness. This will extrude the walls to the outside, and I use the even thickness option. Finally, I can activate to view the normals in the viewport overlay settings to check if my topology is fine and all the normals heading in the right direction. To give this 3D printed object more stability, I add an additional ring at the top of the nozzle, and I will also add a small tiny ring on the inner side as a stop for the metal part of the suction hose.
Thank you.
cut the object completely at the degree. To cut the object completely at a 60 degree angle, I use the Boolean modifier. To do this, I insert a cube and bevel the top. To set the right angle, I use the Measure It add-on. Then I apply the Boolean modifier to the nozzle model and use the cube as the cutting object. This is my final model, which I have to prepare for 3D printing. Now we should do a final visual test of the model and the topology. To do this, we set the viewport shading matcap to a glossy shader, as we did earlier. This helps us to see any flaws in the model geometry. We can also, as mentioned earlier, show the normals to see if the outer walls of the model are set correctly. And there is also the 3D printing toolbox add-on in Blender for some more detailed testing of the model geometry. But this is a topic for another video. After that, we can export the model in STL file format using the STL export add-on, available in the Blender settings. I use Cura to prepare my model for my 3D printer, in my case an Artillery Side Window 1. The Cura settings I use are mostly the same that come with the given side window profile in Cura. Well, I adjusted the infill and support settings to suit my needs. A little more infill rate, for example 60% infill rate, and an infill pattern that works best for my purpose. I also changed the support settings to start at 62 degrees and only from the build plate and nowhere else. I later found that the printing temperature was a bit too high and the support left a lot of marks on the model after removal. To avoid this type of problem, follow the instructions of your filament manufacturer and test the filament with your 3D printer. That's it for today. I hope this video is helpful and gives you some sort of workflow and how to design similar objects. I will upload the model on Thingiverse and add the link in the description. If you have any questions, feel free to add them in the comment section. So, what's left to say? Have fun. Stand up for peace in these difficult times and appreciate the good things in life. With that all said, have a good time and see you next time.